with our discussion, our seventh canto, and we were discussing chapter 13, right? Text 8 onwards. Okay, so we have done. So this is the description of Varnashrama is going on, and in chapter 12 we discuss about the duties of a 11 we discuss duty of Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra and women, and in chapter 12 we discuss the duties of Brahmachari and Vanapras. Now in chapter 13 we are discussing the duties of a perfect person, a sannyasi. So from Shloka text number 1 to 28, the qualities of sannyasis are being explained. We have discussed till 7. Okay. So, today we will continue from text number 8 onward. Today being Saturday, we are having a long time, like 2 hour plan. Generally, we do it for 1 hour. As you know, 8 to 9, okay, and we were doing it on weekends 8 to 10, but today and tomorrow, this weekend, we will do it by 7 to 9. Okay, that's why some people may get it very early, so they are not able to join. Maybe in meanwhile they will join. Okay, no problem. So let's do it. नाशिष्यान् अनुबध्नीत ग्रन्थान् नैवाभ्यस्येत् बहून् नाव्याख्याम् उपयुञ्जीत नारम्भानारभेत्क्वचित्। सो यू शुड फाइंड इट इन योर वेबसाइट और इन योर बुक 7th canto, 13th chapter, text 8. Okay, and you can follow. Now, not Shishyan, disciples, Anbadhanita. One should induce for material benefit. Granthan, unnecessary literature, na, Muhammad, Eva, certainly, Abhisir, should try to understand or cultivate. Pahun, Ganita, or Vyakhyam, discourse, Kupriyam, Jita, should make as a means of livelihood. Na nor arambhan unnecessary offense. Aravhet should attempt to increase kochit at any translation and purport wise divine place AC Bhaktivedan Swami Sri Prabhupada ki jai. A sannyasi must not present allurements of material benefits to gather many disciples. Nor should be unnecessarily read many books or give discourses as a means of livelihood. He must never attempt to read documents unnecessarily. Purport by Shri Prabhupada. Okay, so here one should not seek disciples. Now, what it is said, the verse says, Na Sishyan Anubadnita. Na Sishyan Anubadnita means one should not seek disciples. Bahun Granthan. Bahun Granthan Na Ev Abhyase. Or should one should not study many books. Okay. Na Vyakhyan Upyunjita. Vyakhyan means giving discourses. Nor one should partake in many discourses. Na vyakhyam upyanjita. Okay. Na arambhan aravet kvachit. Arambhan aravet kvachit. So, na. Nor attempt huge projects at any time. Okay. So, he should not, sannyasi should not seek disciples or study many books. Nor giving big discourses, for his own, in increasing his own self, this thing. For Krishna Bhakti, for the pleasure of Krishna, for the pleasure of Guru, he can. purport. So called swamis, okay, so called swamis and yogis generally make disciples by alluring them with material wealth. This is not allowed. Okay, so it was a so-called swamis and yogis generally make disciples by alluring with material benefits. They will show some magics, they will cure the diseases, they will arrange material things for the person. Okay, so people will be attracted just by seeing these kind of material things. Okay. Okay, so there are many so-called gurus. Prabhupada is saying there are many so-called gurus who attract disciples by promising to cure their diseases or increase their material opulences by manufacturing gold. These are lucrative allurements for unintelligent men. A sannyasi is prohibited from making disciples through such material allurements. A sannyasi, okay, so the sannyasi should not do these kind of things just to make disciples showing off many things. Sannyasi sometimes indulge in material opulence by unnecessarily constructing many temples and monasteries. But actually such endeavors should be avoided. Creating unnecessary so many temples, monasteries, and all is not required. Okay, so that is not good for sannyasi. They should not indulge in those activities, and they should try to leave. If it is required from Krishna, from Guru, then they can do. But what it is prohibited, that they should not do it for their own material benefit. Like, I can make many temples, so I will get much respect in society. People will think, oh, he made such a big temple, like that. So temple and monastery should be concentrated for the preaching of Krishna consciousness, the spiritual consciousness, not to provide free hotels for persons who are useful, neither material nor spiritual purposes. Temples, monasteries are not for this purpose. There are some useless fellows are there to make them facilities for them. Okay, because they are not doing anything. Okay, so it is not like dharamsala. It is not like free hotels. Okay. Simply stay there, eat, and people who are interested in spiritual upliftment, spiritual, who want to awaken their spiritual consciousness, it is for them. Okay. So temples and monasteries should be strictly off limits to worthless clubs of waiting. Some people may think, are yaar, this is so nice now. I can simply go and live inside the temple. Food will come, no water. Wonderful, na? So those kind of people are not welcome. Temples are not for that. Temples are for people who are really interested in spiritual awakening. Temples are for them. They can come. They are welcome. Now simply one don't want to work outside because too much pressure. And if you don't work, you won't get food. So they come to temple. Because there are no work, you simply get food. For that kind of people, it is not suggested that you come. It is not good. So in the Krishna consciousness movement, we welcome everyone who agrees at least to follow the movement's regulative principles. At least you follow regulative principles. No illicit sex, no intoxication, no meat eating, and no gambling. In the temples and monasteries, gatherings of unnecessary rejected clergy fellows should be strictly disallowed. The temples and monasteries should be used exclusively by devotees who are serious about the spiritual advancement in Krishna consciousness. Okay. So Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur explains the word Arambhan as meaning Mathadi Vyapara, which means attempts to construct temples and monasteries. The first business of the sannyasi is to preach Krishna consciousness. For sannyasi, first thing is preach Krishna consciousness. But if by the grace of Krishna facilities are available, then he may construct temples and monasteries to give shelter to the serious students of Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, such temples and monasteries are not needed. Okay. Okay. So this is the idea here. Now, generally, many people do that. Sometimes they go on making temples, and big ashrams. That is not required. But main purpose of sannyasi is to preach Krishna consciousness. And if there are facilities, they can make some monastery, some temple for people who are interested in spiritual awakening. Not simply some people are seeking, like they don't want to work, useless fellows. They don't want to work, they just want to remain like useless and eat simply. For them it is not good. Okay. Text 10. Nayatera ashrama prayo dharma hetu mahatmana shantasya samchittasya vipriyad vatyaje. Na not yate of the sannyasi ashrama symbolic danda and commonwealth. Priyayaha almost always dharma hetu, the cause of advance in spiritual life. Maha atmana, who is specially exalted and advanced. Shantasya peaceful. Samchittasya, who has attained the state of being occupied. Vipriya atmana accepts such spirits. Sutta, Jiva, or Tele, Panjiva. A peaceful, occupies person who is factually advanced with spiritual consciousness does not need to accept the symbols of a sannyasi, such as Tridanda and Kamandalu. According to necessity, he may sometimes accept those symbols and sometimes reject them. Okay? Na yatera ashrama prayo dharma hetu mahatma. Shantasya samchittasya vibriyat uta vaktyate. Okay. Yatera ashrama. The stage of paramahamsa. Yati means paramahamsa. So, one who is in the stage of paramahamsa. Yatera ashrama. What is that? Shantasya. Peaceful. Mahatmana. Very advanced. Samchittasya. Equal in all circumstances. Samchittasya. Equal in all circumstances. Okay, so that person is napraya dharmetu, is not meant for producing personal good qualities. Napraya dharmetu. Vipriyat. But vipriyat means he may accept or reject. But vipriyat, he may accept. Utava tyaje. Or he may even tyaje. Reject the symbols of this. It depends. Okay, so the point is the paramahamsa stage of sannyasi is not meant for producing good qualities at this stage of, because at that stage when we accept and reject the symbols of already paramahamsa stage, you don't have this social customs of like showing danda or common. If you want, you can keep, otherwise you can just. Okay. Just 1 minute. Stages of the renounced order of life. Kutichaka, Bahudaka, Parivrajaka Acharya and Paramahamsas. Herein, Srimad Bhagavatam considers the Paramahamsa among the sannyasis, the Mayavadi impersonalists. Sannyasis cannot attain the Paramahamsa state. This is because of their impersonal conception of the Absolute Truth. Four type of sannyasis, and the topmost level is Paramahamsa, and Mayavadis, it is difficult for them. They cannot attain the Paramahamsa state because they are impersonal. Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavan iti Shabda. So, Absolute Truth is perceived in three stages, of which Bhagavan or realization of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is meant for the Paramahamsas. Indeed, Srimad Bhagavatam itself is meant for the Paramahamsas. This Bhagavatam is for Paramahamsas. Parama Nirmatsaranam Satam. Unless one is in the Paramahamsa stage, he is not eligible to understand the Srimad Bhagavatam. For Paramahamsas, or sannyasis in the Vaishnava order, preaching is the first to preach. Such sannyasis may accept the symbols of sannyasis, such as the Dandan commandment, or sometimes they may not. It depends on their preaching requirements. Generally, the Vaishnava sannyasis, being Paramahamsas, are Babajis, and they do not carry a kamandalu or a danda. Such a sannyasi is free to accept or reject the marks of sannyas. His only thought is, where is there an opportunity to spread Krishna consciousness? Babaji is the perfected stage of sannyas, Paramahamsa. They are called Babaji. Like if you see in Iskcon, we have Guru Parampara. So there we say, Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji, Jagannath Das Babaji. So they are like Paramahamsa stage. Babaji is addressed to them. Sometimes the Krishna consciousness movement sends its representatives and sannyasis to foreign countries where the danda and kamandalu are not very much appreciated. Now, sannyasis go foreign countries carrying danda and all may not be allowed there. People, government rules, many things are there. So it may not be allowed, or may not be appreciated. So we send our preachers in ordinary dress to introduce our books and thus. So they can go in ordinary dress, it's not a problem. Our only concern is to attract people in Krishna consciousness. We may do this in the dress of a sannyasi or in the regular dress of a gentleman. Our only concern is to spread this in Krishna. So the point is here, the one should not be too much sticking to the rules. If the main purpose is preach Krishna consciousness, that is the main thing. The highest rule is, you can say, that is the main, yeah, preaching Krishna consciousness. So that is why you see that some places where this devotional attire or this dress is not allowed, there our own sannyasis go for preaching. They put shirt and pant, you know, normal gentleman dress. Sorry. Okay, so they do like that. So the point is that whether one is preaching or not, one cannot say anyway, there the sannyasi dress is not allowed, I cannot go to preach. No. Preaching is the first thing, then others ask. So other rules, if they support your preaching, follow. If no, then we can put those rules on hold for some. Okay. That's a good question. Preaching is the essence. Okay. So this verse, it speaks of the Paramahamsa among the different types of sannyas. The ashram of the Paramahamsas are like peaceful, very great soul. Samchittas equal in all circumstances. Okay, so this means that sannyasi who is immature in his jnana should practice some different like yam rules and regulations for purifying his nature. However, when he is mature in jnana, he does not have to practice. He is now mature. That is called yam. It is said all the rules and regulations are already accomplished now. Okay, so now it depends. At the Babaji stage, Paramahansa stage, depends as per the need of teaching he may do. Okay. Tenth shloka number 10. Avyakta linko vyaktartho manishi vimatta balava kavir mukvad atmanam tadrishtya darshanenam. Although the saintly person may not expose himself to the vision of human society, although a saintly person may not expose himself to the vision of society, by his behavior, his purpose is disclosed. To human society, he should present himself like a restless child. Although he is the greatest thoughtful orator, he should present himself like a dumb man. A great personality, very much advanced in Krishna consciousness, may not expose himself by the science of sannyas. Okay, to cover himself, he may live like a restless child or a dumb person, although he is the greatest orator or poet. Okay, like you see, Jadabharat was like that. Jadabharat was not showing anybody. He was just living simply. Because Jadabharat was thinking that if I show myself to the people, people will come and ask for respect, and they will disrespect, they will disturb me. So he did not want to be disturbed. Okay. So he was just living there. He becomes like this in order to avoid falling from his concentration. He does not have the external characteristics of the sannyas, but he speaks to his purpose of atma. Atrapi udaharantimam itihasam puratanam praharadasya cha samvadam munir ajagarasya cha. Okay. As a historical example of this, learned sages recite the story of ancient discussion between Prahlad Maharaj and a great saintly person who was feeding himself like a python. Okay, so again they are entering into another conversation. That's how it happens in Bhagavatam. Two people are talking and they enter in another conversation. Right? So now Suta and Shaunaka conversation, inside we get Sukadeva and Parikshit Maharaj conversation, said that Narada and Yudhishthira conversation, inside this, now this one. Okay, Prahlad and one another great saintly person. Okay. The saintly person met by Prahlad Maharaj was undergoing Ajagar Vritti. This is called Ajagar Vritti. Okay. Prabhupada used to say this one. Ajagar Vritti, the living condition of a python, which does not go anywhere, but it sits in one place for years and eats whatever is automatically available. Prahlad Maharaj, along with his associates, met his great saint and spoke to him as follows. Ajagar Vritti means the Ajagar. Ajagar is actually python, a big snake. So this snake will not go anywhere, it will just remain one place, nice. Whatever comes, he will eat. That comes, he will remain. Okay. So, the saintly personality whom Prahlad Maharaj met and spoke, that person has taken this called Ajagar Vritti. Okay. I mean, whatever comes, he will accept, otherwise he will not go and work here. Okay, so text number 12 and 13. Okay, so we will go till 9 o'clock today. So in between, if it is disconnected, you can rejoin. Okay, you can rejoin. It may get disconnected. तम श्यानम गर्भोपस्थे कावेर्याम सह सानुनी राजस्वलैस्तनुदेशै निगूढामल तेजसाम ददर्श लोकान विचरन् लोकतत्त्वविवित्सया वृत्तो मात्यै गतिपयै प्ररादो भगवत्प्रियः तम दैट दैट सेंट्री पर्सन श्यानम लाइंग डाउन धरा उपस्थे ऑन द ग्राउंड कावेरिया ऑन द बैंक ऑफ द रिवर कावेरी सह सानी ऑन ए रिज ऑफ द माउंटेन सहिया रजा वलई कवर्ड विद डस्ट एंड डर्ट तन देशई विद ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी निगुड़ा वेरी ग्रेव एंड डीप अमला स्पॉटलेस तेज सांग हूज स्पिरिचुअल पावर ददृशई सा लोका ऑल द डिफरेंट प्लैनेट विचरण Traveling Loka Tattva, the nature of the living beings, especially those who are trying to advance the process. Vivitsaya, to try to understand, Prita Asaran, surrounded Amatyai by royal associate Katipaya, if you, Prarada, Maharaj Prarada, Bhagavatiya, who is always very, very dear to the person who brought it. Praradma, Prarada Maharaj, the most dear servitor of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, once went out touring the universe with some of his confidential associates just to study the nature of saintly person. Thus he arrived at the bank of the Kaveri, where there was a mountain known as Sahya. There he found a great saintly person who was lying on the ground covered with dirt and dust, but who was deeply spiritually advanced. Was covered with dirt and dust, but he was greatly advanced in his spiritual knowledge. Okay, very great, his spiritually advanced personality. Okay, Sanani means there is a river Kaveri and near there is a mountain. Okay, Sahya Mountain. Sahyadri, they call it. Karmana kriti bhirvacha lingair varna samadhi bhina vedanti janayam vai so sab iti na vedicha. Karmana by activities, akriti by bodily features, vacha by words, lingai by symptoms, varna ashrama. Pertaining to the particular material and spiritual divisions of Varna and Ashrama, Adibi and by other symptoms, Na Vidanti could not understand Jana, people in general, Yam, Mumbai, Isa, whether that person Asar was the same person, Iti Dasha, not Baba, or Iti Dasha. Neither by that 70% activities, by his bodily features, by his words, nor by the symptoms of his Varna Ashrama status, could people understand whether he was the same person. Neither by his personal activities, bodily features, words, symptoms of Varnasana status, nothing. People were not able to understand whether he was the same person. Okay. No one could identify him based on his bodily features. Whom? The person who is lying in the dust. So nobody was able to identify him based on his bodily features or his words or his symptoms of his Varnasrama status. The inhabitants of that particular place on the bank of the Kaveri in the valley of the mountain known as Sahya were unable to understand whether the saint was the same man they had known. It is therefore said, Vaishnaver Kriya Mudra Vikena Mujaya. Very important line. Vaishnavera